Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Good morning, students. This is Sunita Gladys Kanaka from Punvidyashram. How are you? I am fine, thank you, children. Today, we are going to learn a new lesson, The Hen by Hector Hugh Munro. Are you ready to learn the new lesson? Then, welcome to the English class. This is a beautiful story with lots of humor. And it has an ironic ending. I am planning to complete this lesson in three parts. First part consists of introduction and gist of the story. Second part consists of lesson explanation. And third part consists of notes and textual exercises. Is that clear, children? Before getting into the lesson, let us see a quick brief introduction about the author. Hector Hugh Munro is better known by his pen name Saki. He was born on 18th December 1870 in Myanmar and died on 14th November 1916 in France. He is widely considered as one of the best short story writers in the English language. He started his career as a journalist, writing for the Westminster Gazette. His first book, The Rise of the Russian Empire, was published in the year 1900. It was followed by a collection of short stories, Not So Stories, in 1902. His witty, mischievous and sometimes macabre, that is horrific, stories satirize Edwardian society and culture. The characters in this fiction are Clovis, Mrs. Sangrail's son, Mrs. Sangrail, Clovis's mother, Jane Martlett and Dora, guests, Storage, Mrs. Sangrail's manservant. In this story, Mrs. Sangrail has a troublesome guest, Jane Martlett, in her house. Another guest is due to arrive. The story is about how the two friends became enemies because of a bronze leghorn, that is a breed of hen. That is why they wanted to get rid of Jane before Dora arrived. It is also about the different methods they use, mostly frightening, to make the unwelcome guest leave. Can her son, Clovis, convince Jane Martlett to leave without his mother's knowledge? Watch the video to get the gist of the story. This story is an extract from Saki's The Hen.
The Hen. Clovis chuckled as he discussed the rather awkward situation which his mother had placed herself in. They already had a rather difficult guest in their house in the person of Jane Martlett. She had been there for 5 days and would probably not leave before a fortnight. Another of Mrs. Sangrail's friends, Dora, was supposed to join their house party that very Thursday. The problem was that Jane and Dora, who had been good friends earlier, no longer saw eye to eye with each other. And it was all because of a hen, which was a bronze leghorn, or of some such exotic breed. Dora had sold it to Jane at quite a high price. Jane thought she would get her money back in a large family of pedigree chickens. But the bird refused to lay eggs, and Jane was disappointed. Jane and Dora could not stop arguing whenever they confronted each other. Mrs. Sangrail decided that she could not put Dora off since she had already postponed her visit once. And nothing short of a miracle would make Jane leave before her self-allotted fortnight was over. There was no way in which they could avoid meeting each other. Clovis offered to try his best. At tea time, Clovis remarked to Jane that servants who had been around for years could become a serious nuisance. Their butler Sturridge, for instance, was at times subject to the most obstinate delusions. These delusions usually centered around one of the guests of the house party. Occasionally, these ideas took a turn which could become dangerous, and that was what was precisely worrying him at the moment. Clovis confided in Jane that Sturridge had taken a fancy about him. He thought of Jane as being Queen Anne, and consequently thought that she should have been dead long ago. This, according to Clovis, made him hostile towards her. So, it was necessary that she keep a sharp lookout all the time and be on her guard. Clovis had his final inspiration in the hall the next morning. Hearing that Miss Martlett was in the morning room writing letters, he told Sturridge that she had wanted to copy the inscription on the basket-hilted sword hanging on the wall. He asked Sturridge to take it to her without the sheath, since it would be less trouble. The butler drew the blade and carried the sword to the morning room. Seeing him with the unsheathed sword, Jane remembered all that Clovis had told her and vanished through the door leading to a back stairway with lightning rapidity. Half an hour later, Clovis was seen driving Jane Martlett and her hastily packed baggage to the station. Clovis assured her that he would make up a credible story to his mother about Jane having been called away by an urgent wire. However, Clovis's effort proved useless, as Dora wrote the same day to say that she was postponing her visit.
How was it? Good, isn't it? Did you understand the gist of the story? I'll be doing the elaborate explanation in part 2. Okay, children. Now, here ends part 1. Thank you for watching. Bye from Sunita Gladys Kanaka.